Hi there, my name is Dr. Lorrie Kirshenbaum, and I happen to be honored with being the chair of the Outstanding Early Career Investigator Award this year for the BCVS meeting. I'm delighted to introduce one of the finalists, Dr. Johannes from the University of Heidelberg, who is one of the finalists, and his work entailed disrupting the interaction between CAM kinase 2 and histone deacetylase 4 as an epigenetic therapy for heart failure. And I'm delighted that Johannes is here with me today, and he's going to tell us a little bit about his research. Johannes.
Yeah, thank you very much, Dr. Kirshenbaum. Yeah, I'm pretty happy to present this data tomorrow. So actually, my lab is interested in calcium calmodulin kinase 2, CAM kinase 2, for many years. CAM kinase 2 is a critical regulator of heart failure. It drives pathological remodeling of heart failure. But the problem was that there are many targets were suggested that drive pathological remodeling. Our lab found that HDAC4 is phosphorylated by CAM kinase 2, or it associates with CAM kinase 2. But the question was whether this is really important. So what we did, we engineered a mouse model in which HDAC4 cannot bind to CAM kinase anymore. And then we investigated this mouse model. And what we found was very interesting. We could show that this mouse model was resistant to heart failure. So these mice, when we applied pressure overload or myocardial infarction, did not develop the full degree of heart failure. So we are now pretty sure that the interaction between CAM kinase and HDAC4 is really critical for the development of heart failure. And based on this finding, we pursued also more translational studies and looked for compounds and peptides that can disrupt the binding between these two molecules.
That's terrific. Very exciting work. How do you see this unfolding perhaps in the future toward therapies that might be able to treat heart failure or patients with hypertrophic cardiomyopathy?
Yeah, so we are just at the beginning. I mean, the problem that we faced was when we inhibit CAM kinase, then we were not sure what else we inhibit. CAM kinase had many functions besides phosphorylating HDAC4. It also handles calcium. It regulates the handling of calcium, the handling of it regulates myofilaments. It also regulates many other functions outside the heart. So, for example, memory and fertilization is regulated by CAM kinase. So, by this approach, we are now able to only specifically target one function of HDAC4 of CAM kinase 2. And we have now compounds in our hands. The first compounds in our hands that really specifically disrupt the binding. And we are now doing chemistry and also early in vivo work. So we go in mouse models and try to show that disrupting this interaction is an approach to combat heart failure. There's a lot of work to do, but we have already compounds in our hands that that are kind of lead compounds in this process.
That's absolutely terrific. So it sounds like a new opportunity, an exciting opportunity, to potentially study and treat heart disease, heart failure in particular. That's terrific, wonderful. How long have you been doing this work?
So I became interested in this work a long time ago during my postdoctoral work that I did in Dallas, UT Southwestern with Eric Olson. So there I found the molecular basis of this, and then about 5 years ago I started to work on this mouse model, and also a few years ago we started to really look for compounds and peptides that affect the interaction.
That's terrific. Yeah, very, very exciting. It's not often that you come up with a project and it works out to be so fruitful, but this is very exciting and very clinically relevant. Congratulations on some outstanding and some very, very important clinical work.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.